is so important to you that he walked back into Trinity's life? Man, Nukey's a bad man, a bad person. Now, frankly, I don't even see why you gave him the time of day in the first place. Ever since high school, he ain't been nothing but a problem child. Fighting, stealing, drug dealing, which led to murder. Come on now, baby. The man killed his own brother. But what? Now that he's supposed to be getting released on good behavior, it's gonna take he a changed man. Man, please, that man is a criminal. Period.
Just put this on. Why are you doing all that talking? Getting on my nerves.
Could you move the wig? But really though, I don't understand. I'm telling you right now, I don't want him seeing my baby, and he better not come over here either. How the hell you put this on? Oh, okay, hold on. See, I'm mad, that's why I can't get it. Hold on, work with me. I still can't get it.
I got it. Just go.
If he think about coming over here, he better come prepared for a good ass whooping, because I ain't having it. I'll tell you that right now, for real.
Listen at you. Lucas, stop talking crazy. Nukey is her father. You are her dad. The man that's raised her since she was 4 years old. But we can't pretend he's not her father. That's just not right. And you call yourself a man of God. What would Jesus do?
Jesus will lay his hands on him for trying to interrupt his family. That's what Jesus would do. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to lay these hands on him if he step foot on my porch. I'm going to tell you that right now.
Put your hands down. Remember, he just from the servant 10 years in prison.
And what that supposed to mean? Girl, you know I'm doing 2 days in a gym every week. You already know.
Doing what? Taking your swim lessons? Boy, stop. Don't get beat up on your own porch.
Oh, so you just gonna stand there and stick up for your absent baby daddy over your husband?
Anyway.
Out of all those book bags I didn't buy. All them school clothes.
Like I was saying, he's her father, and he has every right to want to reconnect with his only child. He loves her, and you know that. He's made bad mistakes after bad mistakes, but that doesn't change the fact that he's her father. He cared. Before the accidental murder, Nukey and I was planning our future. He thought the gun was empty, or he never would have pointed it at his brother. Killing his brother, his mother's other son. That truly devastated him. And think about Mama Cozy, losing two sons on the same day. One to death, the other to the penal system. She never even visited him in jail or attended any of his court appearances. Imagine how you would feel if your mama put you out and made you feel like you weren't wanted. It is what it is. Sorry, not sorry, that you're in your feelings about Nukey getting out and wanting to repair his relationship with his now 14 years old daughter. It is what it is. But my baby has my approval of seeing her father.
Well, I don't like it. I don't agree with it. And like I said before, if he comes step his foot on my porch, we gonna have a problem. That's all I'm saying.
Lucas, Don't be like that. She's still your baby girl. You don't have to worry. But let her know that you are happy for her to have a relationship with her father. Don't make her feel like she has to choose.
But Stella. Stella, love, young, I love you. I love my daughter. I love this family. But why we gotta deal with Nukey? Okay, yes, you and him had a relationship back in the day, and from that dysfunctional connection, the God blessed the world with Trinity. Okay, I get that. But life is fine without him. I mean, that's all I'm saying.
Lucas, Arthaniel, Young, love you. I love this family. And our daughter loves us all. You stepped in and did what a lot of brothers wouldn't do. Took on the responsibility of another man's neglect and raised another man's child as your own. Thank you, baby. Baby, there's no need to tell you. As far as I can really recall, love has been here for you. So you don't have to worry at all. I sacrificed my time. I make sure you're satisfied. And there's no hard thing to the joy I bring. I want to give you all my love. That's all I want to do. Every hour, baby.
I want you to know
my love is yours. That's all I want to do.
Every day,
every minute, every hour. That I need so much, and I am about to explore freely, completely. Everything you want, I'll be. Good love, down to the last drop, and I don't want to stop. That's all I want to do. Every day. Woo! My love is yours. That's all I want to do. Now let me give me a kiss. Let me go pick up Trinity from Granny's. And put some clothes on.
Okay, honey bunny. Still don't want him over here. And he better not come over here either. Let him stay right where he at, the penitentiary. I've been raising that girl since she was 4 years old. I don't need no help. Nope, nope, nope. Hey, you better not took my truck. You know gas $7.99. Man! Yeah, who is it?
What's up, man?
Oh. Nukey. Woo! Did you just step your foot on my porch?
Yep. Here to see my little girl.
No, you didn't come to my house. And talking about you want to see your little girl. You don't got no little girl, man. Trinity is my little girl. And I don't want you coming over here.
Wait a minute. Trinity is my daughter, and I will be back. Now, I appreciate you stepping up and helping raise her and looking out for her as if she was your own. But that's where you're getting things twisted at.
Oh, I'm getting twisted, okay.
She's my little girl. That's where you're getting things twisted at. And I will be back.
Mm-hmm. Well, she ain't here. Stella went to go pick her up from your mother's house. So if you run along, you might catch up to her. Because don't want you coming over here.
I'll be back.
Let me tell you this too, though. If you hurt her, I will hurt you. Because she's my little girl. Now get the hell out of my house, bro. He actually stepped on my porch.
Sam, you can't have rice and gravy without the gravy. The devil is alive. That should be fine. We're expecting about 20 people at the luncheon, so bring about 30 biscuits. Hey, First Lady. Oh, bless your heart. Okay. Listen, First Lady just walked in. I'll see you next Wednesday, 3 o'clock. All right. God bless you.
Honey, who was that? I thought you was having your sister to cater the luncheon to help her business.
That was her. And if she don't get it right this time, I'm done with her. Running a business like that. You can't want to cook sometimes but have the nerve to have a catering business. Make it make sense. Told me one time that the people were getting on her nerves because they wanted dressing with their turkey.
What? That girl is a mess.
Yeah.
But did you hear that Nukey was getting out of jail?
Yeah. Now, you know, don't nothing happen in this city without me knowing about it. Man, Nukey, me and that boy ran tough back in the day. Man, as kids, we did all kind of stupid kid stuff. Nothing that got us into too much trouble or anything. But we did all kind of crazy stuff. Man,
Now, Levi.
Yeah, first one.
You're a grown man to preach the gospel now. Now, if he's not ready to turn his life around, he's not welcome around here.
What are you saying, love? Nukey is my friend, and I can't turn my back on him. His soul counts too. What kind of man would I be if I'm standing up here preaching the gospel about forgiveness and repentance and about how our Lord will save our soul if I look down on him? I can't do that. I won't do that. And if Nukey shows up around here, we're going to welcome him with open arms. Besides, you don't want to catch hell from his mother, do you?
Mother Cozy don't even deal with her son. She gave him up after the accident. She said that was the last straw. Nukey killing his own brother? Now, that's messed up. Mm-mm-mm.
Well, you know, hey, Sebastian, how you doing, brother?
Pastor Lewis.
How things going?
Same old, same old. I got something I've been wanting to speak with you about. I feel it's time that you should know.
Sebastian, don't come in here with that. Not now. This is not the place.
What's going on? They changing things up down on y'all job again? You know what? Every time they bring in new management, they start making changes. Me, I say if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Baby.
Huh?
They laying you off?
No.
Pastor, it's... Pastor, it's bigger than that.
Sebastian, no! Don't do this! Not now, not today!
Cecilia, what are you talking about? Why are you shaking? What's wrong?
You know what? Nothing's wrong. The truth just needs to be told. Pastor, me and Cecilia slept together and... It's time to come clean.
Brother, you come to my church to tell me that you slept with my queen?
Levi, baby, it only happened once. That's all. That's all.
Only once? What you mean only once? Cecilia, tell him the truth. Tell him that baby that you're carrying isn't his.
What?
Tell him that I'm the father, Cecilia.
Wait, you're the father of our unborn baby? Wait, little Levi... Isn't little Levi? Sebastian, have you lost your mind? Not only did you sleep with my wife, First Lady Lewis, but she's carrying your kid? Baby, you didn't step out on our marriage, did you? Baby, you didn't have unprotected sex with this man. You didn't, baby. Baby, you didn't... You didn't go out have an affair and got yourself pregnant, but you've been leading me on to believe that we have a baby on the way? I had a vasectomy years ago, but as a man of God, I believed that God was blessing us with this child, so I thought I produced a baby boy. But you knew, all this time, you knew that you had made a baby with this piece of this piece of crap. I can't believe this. I can't believe this. You hurt me. No, baby, you hurt me bad. Sebastian, brother, I suggest that you leave my church immediately. Before I forget that I'm a pastor and be responsible for your family planning a funeral.
Look, Pat, Pastor, look, man, I'm sorry for touching your wife, man. And, come on, man. And I'm sorry for bringing harm to your marriage, but I couldn't keep living this lie, man. The truth needed to be told. Cecilia, I'll talk to you soon.
Levi! Levi! Levi, baby, I'm sorry. Put the gun away. I'm sorry. Put the gun away. I love you, Levi. I love our marriage. Don't leave me. We can get through this. Levi, I love you. I'm sorry. Lord, I'm sorry. I love you. Help me.
Trinity! Girl, I thought you was looking in the picture book. You fooling with that phone. That's all you youngins do is mess around with them phones.
Grandma Cozy, have you seen this new TikTok dance they just dropped? Come on, let's do it.
Now, you know your grandma ain't moved like that since 1979, right before I had your daddy. But come on, I'm gonna follow you.
Okay. Ready?
Bye. Because if you love us all I had.
Come on, Grandma.
Yeah. Hey. I got it. Yes, Grandma got it. I still got it.
Yes, you do. Dad looks so funny. What grade was he in on this picture?
Child, your daddy was in 11th grade, thinking he was God's gift to the world. That was his favorite shirt. He wore about 2 to 3 times a week. Couldn't tell the boy nothing. He thought he was clean. All the girls wanted him.
Other than his clothes, he was cute. I see why Mama was so crazy about him.
Yeah, it was handsome. I suppose he still is. He always got into something. Doing things he had no business doing. Your Uncle Monroe had big plans for his future. But he couldn't stay away from his older brother, Kingston. They call him Nukey. I call him what I name him from birth, Kingston. Let me calm down, get my pressure up. Trinity, baby. Your dad was smart and very ambitious. He could have been something special, made something out of his life. But he was just so hard-headed, wouldn't listen to nothing I told him. I think he was mad that his dad had left us. So he rebelled at every chance he could. But I still love my only son. Pray for him. Send him money for his books. Just couldn't stand to visit him. But God knows I love my son.
He got sent away when I was so little. 4 years old, and Mom, she never really took me to the prison to see him. He only called every now and then, so I barely even talked to him. I love Lucas. He's been a father to me since we met.
Uh-huh.
But he's just not my father. I think he hates my dad. That's why Mom never talks about Dad around Lucas. I don't want to hurt Lucas, but I want to see my dad when he gets out. I want to talk to him, go to the mall with him. Make TikToks with him. Grandma Cozy, I want a relationship with my dad.
Oh, yes, baby.
am I wrong for feeling like this?
Oh, child, you're not wrong. A father's love and relationship with his daughter is a special love. He's the first man you ever loved. Some of the hardest fellas walking the earth folds like a cupcake when it comes to the daughters. Oh, they'll play dress up, go places they don't want to go, break someone's neck and go to the penitentiary for someone hurting that little girl. Lucas will understand. He knows he's not your biological father. He's not that stupid. Oh, your mother, she's a good mother. She's only doing what she feels is best for the family. You see, you've been around me all your life. Just because her and your dad split and he was sent off to prison for accidentally shooting his brother. That didn't make my love for you lessen, or your mother try to keep you from me. And when your dad gets home, she won't keep you from him either. So don't you worry your pretty little self about that. You remain a 14-year-old kid and love your parents, all of them. You've been blessed to have two men, two daddies.
Hi, Mom. We were just talking about you.
Really? I hope it was good.
No. Get in here, girl, and have a seat. You want some tea?
Oh, no. Kind of in a hurry. Lucas and I have some things to do.
Oh. Trinity is worried about how things will go once Kingston gets out of jail. She feels Lucas will have a problem with her getting to know and spending time with her father. But I told her you wouldn't let that happen. Right, Stella?
Right. Trinity, baby, don't worry. You'll have lots of chances to spend with your dad. Lucas won't have a problem. Lucas loves you and wants the very best for you. A relationship with the father is what every girl wants. Lucas understands that. He won't have a problem. And like your grandma said, I won't let it happen.
Right, all right.
But I don't want to hurt Lucas' feelings. He's been treating me like I was his own daughter for a very long time now. I don't want him to feel like, well, I don't love him anymore. Oh. Because I do love him. But I love my dad also. I can't wait to see him. I have so much to tell him.
Okay, Trinity, tell your grandmother bye. Thank you so much for keeping her last night, and thanks for all that you do.
Okay, see y'all Sunday at church. Trinity, you be good now. And tell that teacher call me next time she wants to question your honesty. I'll give her some smoke.
Okay, Granny.
Call my grandbaby liar.
All right.
Stella, take care of my baby.
All right.
Now, God, you know I love my children and did the best I could with them. I only knew what I knew, so I only did what I knew to do. I know it wasn't right to act like I had no son after Kingston killed Monroe. I was so tore up. Losing my baby boy because of the stupidness of my oldest boy. Buried my son, then acted like I buried my other son. Not visiting him, not attending court, not writing back to him. It's like I threw him away. But I kept the connection to his daughter, Trinity. Forgive me, Lord, for treating my son that way. And God, give him a mind to forgive me as well. There has to be better days. Ooh. Hey.
but hang on in there, cause better days are coming. Oh, oh, oh. You've seen good, you've seen bad, you've been happy and sad, but just remember, ooh, that better days, better days are coming. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Friends will leave you all by yourself, but don't cry, cause better days are
days.
Mama, mama.
Son.
I love you, mama.
Oh, son.
Wow, mama. Oh, wow, it's so good to see you. You looking so good. Wow. I'm so happy to be sitting across from you.
Oh.
Man, since you never came to the jail to visit me, I always prayed to God that one day I'll be able to get out and you still be alive so that I could see that precious smile of yours.
Oh, son, I'm glad to see you. Oh, you hungry? Want something to eat? I got some leftover turkey and dressing I can warm for you.
No. I'm fine. I just stopped by to catch up with Trinity and her mom. I stopped by her house and Lucas said that they would be over here.
Mm. So,
she's getting big, ain't she?
Oh, yes.
I know she is. Wow. Oh. So, have you heard from Pastor?
Oh, let me tell you first about your daughter, Trinity. Oh, you know, she's a handful now.
Oh,
oh, yes, but a sweet kid. Oh, talented, smart and going places. That is if she don't let the peer pressure of messing with boys get in her head.
Yeah.
Well, she's been coming over here at least 2 to 3 times a month for the past 3 years.
Oh,
you
my
know,
God.
I've watched her grow into a fine young child.
Yes. You still talk to Pastor Lewis? I mean, you go over to the church still?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
I got a couple of letters from him, but he never came to see me either. I guess he's still mad at me for that little misunderstanding we had.
No. Well, he's doing fine. But the street is talking about his precious wife.
Oh, wait. Well, huh? What?
The first lady is other folks' lady.
What?
She done messed around and got herself pregnant with another man's baby. Then stand up there in church like she's some perfect angel. She need to come correct and keep it real. We all already know.
Whoa. Wait a minute. You telling me they having marital problems like that? That just goes to show you. There's no perfect person, just a perfect God.
Ooh, Well, listen at you. What do you know about a perfect God and stuff?
Well, I'm not the same old confused Nukey I was before I got incarcerated.
Amen.
I asked God to forgive me for my sins. But can I ask you something, Mama?
Yes, baby.
Why did you just throw me away? Why did you disown me? I mean, I know I wasn't the best kid and I didn't do much to make you proud, but I'm still your child. And you made me feel like a motherless child for so many years.
Son, you hurt me. I was hurt bad. When your father left, you became the man of the house. I depended on you to lead things and be a good example for your brother. But instead, you acted a fool. You didn't do right at all. So when your careless, irresponsible actions took the life of my baby boy, oh, your brother, that was it. I was through with you. I blamed God. Why would he let me birth such a terrible son? My firstborn, my little man, my little Kingston. Why would God bless me with such a bad son? I couldn't deal with it anymore. I couldn't deal with you. My husband left me. My baby boy left me due to the hands of my oldest son. What was I to do? I was devastated. I was lost. I was filled with hurt and hate at the same damn time. I know it wasn't right, but son, you have to put yourself in my shoes. Remember, I grew up without my mother. My drunk dad killed her. So at an early age, I felt alone. People I trusted did me wrong. Sexually abused. Mistreated. Unloved. Completely scarred by my own childhood. So when I lost my baby boy, I felt that was it. I couldn't take any more disappointment. So I gave you up in my mind. But I continued to love and take care of Trinity in your place. All I could ask you, you would forgive me, son. Forgive me for treating you like you never existed. I'm sorry. Son, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry for being a disappointment. I'm sorry. not taking the proper responsibility to care for Monroe. Instead, I'm responsible for his death. I'm sorry for not being there for you, caring for you the way a son should. Why God keep looking out for me when I've been no earthly good? I pray in my cell every night, and I just don't understand why he always spared my life. He had to take my little brother's life. I just don't understand. I don't understand what I'm not deserving. I'm not deserving. It should have been me. I asked God that every night, and I just didn't understand when the riots broke out. My enemies would pass right by my cell, and they wouldn't harm me at all. But Mama, I started to read my Bible.
Praise God.
And I started going to church on Sundays. And I accepted Christ in my life as my personal Savior. I told him I wanted to be born again. I wanted to be new. So Mama, I stand today as a new person. I stand today in front of you, a new son. I read in the Bible that 2 Chronicles 7:14 says that if my people would call my name, and humble themselves in prayer, and seek his face, that's when he gonna heal. That's when he's gonna heal the land.
Yeah.
And Mama, I forgive you just as the Lord our God has forgiven me.
Father, I need you to hear me. You said in your word that you know the plan that you have for me. So God, I ask you, how does this pain fit inside your plan? But God, not my will, but your will. Thank you, God. Thank you.
Honey, you are truly a strong, purposeful man of God. And I have failed you as a wife. And adultery is grounds for divorce, as in the word. But you have forgiven me and want me to continue as your wife. It's amazing. From this day forward, I will walk by your side. Us agreeing to get counseling was the best decision for our marriage. I'm sorry for stooping to the unthinkable or sharing my body with another man. There's no excuse. But the truth of the matter is, I started to feel alone. And with your traveling and my so-called friends filling my head up with thoughts of you enjoying yourself with other women, it made me feel stupid. So when Sebastian came on to me, I liked it. The extra attention, it felt good.
But I know that was nothing but the devil working to destroy our union. And I allowed it to happen. But baby, Levi means nothing to me. Never did. I simply one day slipped up and put my shield down and got in bed with another man. Levi, I'm ashamed. And I have brought shame into this ministry, and yet you still want me to stay? You want this baby to be born into a loving situation and not ever feeling unwanted. Thank you, husband. Thank you, friend. Thank you, man of God.
Baby, you're my wife. I love you. The enemy may have tried to ruin our union, but the God we serve, he gets the last word. There's a line in our vows that said, till death do you part. And that's exactly what it's going to take for me to leave you, love. Death. Until then, I'm gonna keep loving you. I'm gonna keep building a life with you. I'm gonna keep growing and grow old with you. And I promise to love this life that we are soon blessed to receive. I've had some good days. I've had some hills to climb. I've had some weary days. Some sleepless nights. But when I look around, yeah, I think things over. All of my good days outweigh my bad days. So I won't complain. Sometimes the clouds hang low. Hey God, I can hardly see the road. I ask the question, Lord, why so much pain? My weary eyes, they can't see. So I'll just say, thank you, Lord. I won't complain. God, he has been so good to me. Good to me, better than this whole world for you could ever be. He's been so good to me. You know, he tried all of my tears.
way. Hey God. Share my midnight still today. So instead of complaining, I lift my eyes towards heaven and say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I won't complain. God has been so good to me. He's been good to me. Better than this world or you could ever be. He's been so good to me. You know, he drank all of my tears away. Say, my midnight's here today. So instead of complaining, I learned to lift my eyes towards heaven and say, thank you, Lord. I'm hurting on the inside and nobody understands, but thank you, Lord. Sometimes I feel like I'm dying, I'm dying, I'm dying, I'm dying, I'm dying, but thank you, Lord. I won't turn back, I won't turn back, I won't turn back, but thank you, Lord. 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 I won't complain. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Now, Trinity, I love you. You are my daughter. And I love you very, very much. So it's okay that your father's getting out of jail and he want to have a relationship with you. And why wouldn't he? You're smart, kind, beautiful. You got a bright future ahead of you, girl.
See, baby, we are a family, a true family. So when difficult times come, we don't run and hide. But we face them head on, and we ask God to help us deal with them. So when your father comes for you, you don't have to feel guilty of wanting to see your father. It's okay to love your father. And believe me, I know your father loves you.
Awesome, Mom. Awesome, Dad. I didn't want to hurt you, but I miss my daddy, and I wish he never went to jail in the first place. Should I be expecting a little brother or sister, seeing we're a big happy family?
I ain't saying we were that happy. It's been 14 years since a human passed in this body. I think about it.
Ain't a bad idea, though, Trinity. Have us a little new bundle of joy running around up in here.
Yeah, yeah, Mom, why not?
That might be good.
I'll get it.
Trinity, girl, hey! Is that my little teenager all grown up? Girl, you pretty just like your mama.
She sure is. Mm-hmm. Hey, Nukey, I'm glad you're out, man.
Huh? Hey, Lucas, okay? Hey, Stella, you looking good as usual. Get over here, let me get by your mama.
Glad to see you out in one piece. Mm.
So, are you home for good? Like, not going back?
Like, never, ever, ever going back, girl.
Sit down. Take a load off and let's chat.
Let's chat.
Well, y'all chat. I got some runs I need to make anyway. So, you know, like I said, Nukey, I'm glad you're back, bro. You know, you got a lot of catching, making up to do. But I'm glad you're back. I'm going to take off and let y'all chat. You know, I'll be back in a little bit.
Can I get you anything? Soda? Water?
No.
Iced tea?
Give me a minute. I'll be back, though.
See ya.
No, I'm fine. I just want to talk to our daughter, that's all. Just have a little conversation with her. Trinity, I'm sorry I failed you as a father. I mean, not being there for you on your first day of kindergarten and stuff. Or with you when you got scared in your bedroom and you thought something was under the bed and you ran out. Or maybe when a little special friend came. Did she come yet?
Daddy.
Girl, did she come?
Yes, she came last year, but you can still take me out to dinner to celebrate.
No, I will.
Nukey, it's glad to see you home. Really good to see you. You're welcome to come over anytime and see Trinity. I know it's gonna be a rough start now that you're out. Lucas has been a great dad to Trinity already, but just do what you can. Be the father you wished you could be.
I will. I ain't never, ever, ever going nowhere. You know that dinner that you was talking about, girl? Dinner you want, dinner it is. Come on, let's go.
Hey, babe, mama, you know you can go to dinner with us too if you like.
Come on, Mom.
Come on.
No. It's best I stay here. Go on with your baby.
Sure is. Come on, girl.
Announcements for today, June 5th, 2022.
Yes, uh-huh.
Yes. In honor of Mother Linda's birthday today, we will be having ice cream and cake following service today in the gym.
Praise the Lord.
Please watch and keep your kids in check, because we are not going to have the same thing we had last week at Brother Ronnie's repast.
Amen.
Also, if you're an active member of the choir, please have your dues paid up by next Thursday.
That's right.
Amen. If you're planning on going to Chicago with us for the National Holy Ghost Choir Sing Sing.
Come on.
Yes.
We need the money. We need the money.
We need to pay them dues. Pay them. Yes. Pay them.
Sister Stephanie is in need of donations to help get her car back. The bank repoed it.
Ooh, Lord have mercy.
Because she hadn't paid a car note in 4 months.
So she paid it
yeah. In spite of receiving a healthy PPE loan for daycare.
Oh my.
Yes. Yes. Founding Church.
Praise saints.
Pastor is asking and encouraging all members. I repeat, all members to purchase a ticket to Mr. C.L. Woodson's upcoming stage play.
That's right.
They're running a contest to see which church would represent with the most members in attendance.
Oh my.
Pastor said, don't make him look foolish by not showing
all
support.
Right now.
All right?
Pastor
we have to support Brother Woodson because he is one of us.
Yes, he is. That's right.
That concludes this week's church announcements. Amen?
Amen.
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 Yes, sir. Lord.
Praise God. Praise God.
Yes, God.
Praise God.
Yeah, God.
All right.
Oh, my Lord. Yes, praise
you. Mm. I told you. I told you. Mm. Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Welcome to the house of the Lord.
Yes. Amen.
Before I bring Pastor up to preach his sermon, I would like to confess to a few things that are getting rumored in the community. Uh-huh. There ain't no rumor. That's real. Like everyone on earth, I'm not perfect. And in my imperfections, I made a terrible sin and committed adultery. I sinned against our union of marriage, which resulted in an untimely pregnancy of a soon-to-be baby boy. Wow.
Talk about it first.
That is not the child of my husband, the Honorable Levi Lewis.
Yes, God. Hallelujah.
I walk with guilt. And I walk with shame.
Have mercy, Lord.
I walk with knowing how bad I hurt my soulmate. My friend, my husband, my everything.
Mm-hmm.
Ephesians 2, verse 8.
Okay. Well, all right, come on, let's go.
For by grace,
yes,
you have been saved through faith.
Come on, lady.
And it's not your own doing.
Not your own.
But it is a gift of God.
Yes.
Yes.
All right.
Amen. If it wasn't for his grace, no one would be here today.
Oh, you want somebody to beat that?
If it wasn't for his grace,
yes.
Our terrible life choices would not be forgiven.
Yes.
And our sins washed away.
Uh-huh.
Because we serve a mighty God.
Yes.
They give us ample opportunities to get it right.
That's right. That's right.
But we can't do this on our own.
Yeah.
No, we can't do it. No, we can't.
Because
the enemy plans to steal, kill, and destroy
every day.
My Lord. So when things came out to my husband about my wrongdoing, I got on my knees. And I prayed.
Amen.
And
glory.
I asked God to please forgive me.
Glory, God.
Yes, God.
I asked God to deliver me from bad thoughts, to remove wicked ways that may attempt to enter my mind that is not Christ-like.
Yes, Lord.
And to place a covering over my marriage.
Yes, God.
And to strengthen my husband.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Despite.
Yes.
How I embarrassed him.
Help her, Lord.
Help her, God.
And his ministry, I'm sorry.
Somebody help her. Somebody. Come on. Yeah.
Honey.
It's going to be all right.
Yeah. Honey, let me add something. Just let me add a few words.
Yes, all right, Pastor.
Come on. Come on, Pastor. Come on, sir.
This lady here
uh-huh.
is my wife.
All right. Yeah.
My wife.
Amen.
Now, did she make a mistake? Yes, she did.
Come on, preacher.
But let me see a show of hands of all of you in here that have not. We are all flawed.
Keeping my hands down.
Y'all hear me?
Amen.
We are all flawed.
Yes.
And at any given moment,
yes, sir.
We're just a hair away from making one bad decision that could cause future
yes.
and life.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
But God.
What God?
But God.
But God.
Gives us grace.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Ephesians
come on, Doc.
1:7
uh-huh.
says we have redemption
uh-huh.
through his blood.
Yes, sir.
Forgiveness
uh-huh.
of sin
yes.
in accordance
yes.
to his riches and grace.
Yes.
Now, church,
yes, sir.
Saints, I don't want to stand up here and pretend I'm so saved uh-huh. that
well,
I don't hurt.
Well,
yes, sir.
I had to go on my knees.
Uh-huh.
Yes, sir.
And I had to talk to the Lord.
Yes,
I know you
yes,
did.
Yes.
I told the Lord. I said, Lord,
uh-huh.
I trust you.
Yes.
But I want to kill him.
Yes.
Leave
yes.
this church,
come on.
That woman, and this city.
Uh-huh.
But I heard the Lord speak to my heart.
Yes. Yes.
And it took me to 2 Corinthians 12:9.
You want somebody to feed now?
He told me,
uh-huh.
your brother a long time ago
yes,
came to me and said, God, remove this thorn from my side.
Yes.
Three times. And I'm going to tell you the same thing
yes.
that I told your brother.
Uh-huh.
My grace.
Yes.
My grace.
My grace.
My grace is sufficient.
Yes.
And my and my power
yes.
works best
yes.
in your weakness.
Uh-huh.
In weakness, uh-huh.
Come
yes,
on,
yes,
preacher.
Yes, 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 yes.
Thank you, God.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, God.
Nukey.
Yes, sir.
You know what? I'm pleased to welcome a longtime friend of mine.
Oh, yes.
We were some deviant little boys.
Oh, yes, you were.
Growing yes, up, getting in all kinds of trouble.
Oh, oh yes.
Yes, God.
Y'all don't understand. Deviant little boy.
All right, yeah. All right.
My Lord.
But, Nukey, would you like to come on up here and say a few words?
Yes, yeah. sir. Thank you, Pastor.
Hey,
praise
God.
Amen.
Praise
the Lord,
God.
So
amen.
Good
amen.
To see you. Love you, Doc.
Boy, you look good.
Yeah, man. You crazy. Yeah. Praise amen. The Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, somebody.
Praise the Lord.
I am so elated to be here. Giving honor to God, to the pastor of this house, yes, our sir. Pastor, and the first lady.
Yes.
First, before I start, I want to thank you guys for sharing your personal business.
Bless you.
And being so transparent.
Yes, sir.
This should be a lesson learned by all of the followers under your leadership.
Come on,
now. All right. That all of us are due to an attack
yes.
by
yes.
the enemy. And
yes.
the devil is always on the attack.
Oh, yes, he is.
I've been out of away for about 10 years. I've been out of prison right now about a week. And I was away from my favorite girls in the whole wide world. My mother, the mother lovely Cozy,
yes.
and my daughter, Trinity. I love you, girl. And I've been away from them. And I can tell you this here. It's been something for me.
Right.
But I'm going to tell you, God showed, delivered, and set my soul free.
Yes. Yes.
He saved my soul
yes.
from burning in hell.
Yes.
And when I say, he has been good. Hey.
Yes.
forgive me, Pastor. I am trying to contain myself.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God. I'm trying to contain myself because God has been good to me.
Yes, He has.
You know, I sit and think about all that I've been through. And I think about how good God has been to me. And I think about how other people turned their backs on me.
Come on, son.
But God never turned His back on me. And I am so happy to be living this day, and I plan on being a better person, living this life, a spiritual walk with my mother, Mother Cozy, every day to become a better person. You know what everybody else gave up on me?
Well.
And everybody else saw the worst in me? He saw the best in me.
Come on. Oh.
Go ahead.
It's all right. He saw the best in
me.
When everyone else around only sing the worst. Can I say it one more time? He saw the best in me. When everyone else around only sing the worst in me. Do anybody know what I'm talking about? He saw the best in me. See the worst in me. Oh, I'm gonna say he's all the best. When everyone else threw me away, yeah. Oh, he's seen the worst in me. It doesn't matter where you've been. He only sees you for who I am. He's mine. I'm his. It doesn't matter where you've been. He only sees me for who I am. Let the church say with me, yeah. He's mine, I am His. It doesn't matter. I was locked up. Everybody threw me away, but the best in me. Yeah.
No, what I'm talking about.
Yes, hallelujah.
Somebody give God some praise for Brother Mason. Y'all can do better than that when you see God make some changes. Go ahead and shout glory for Brother King. He left here.
Yes.
Nukey. But he came back. The man that God set out for him to be Kingston.
Glory.
Brother, I'm here for you. If you need anything or just somebody to talk to, you feel free to reach out to me. Anytime. Yes. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah.
That was an amazing service. I'm so shocked to see the changes in your father. Nukey has really changed and gave his life to Christ.
Yeah, I just hope he's for real. Not on, using God's name, to be tricking us, because I know he learned some tricks in prison. How to get over on people.
Oh, my God. There you go.
I'm just saying.
He seems pretty serious to me. And
too.
Besides, Granny said they're on the way to pick me up.
And where do you guys think you're going, young lady?
I think to eat, but it doesn't matter to me. Let me call her.
Hello, Trinity.
Granny, y'all almost ready? We're here and I'm waiting on you and Dad to pick me up.
Oh, baby, what? We'll be there soon. Need to take my medicine and we'll be on our way. Got me an iPhone here.
Oh, Mama. You know what? You was right about what you said about First Lady. Having somebody else's baby. And then Pastor talking about he don't stay with her. I mean, he got to be Jesus' best friend.
Well, that's between them and God.
I guess so.
I'm so proud of you.
Thank you, Mama.
You were a lost soul.
Yes, ma'am.
But it took going to prison for you to be found.
Yes, ma'am.
Praise God. Oh, I live to see it.
Yes, God.
I prayed many years for this day.
I love you, Mama.
Oh, I love you too, son. Well, are you ready to go?
I guess I can't be.
Taking all that
I gotta see what I did with my phone before I leave out the house.
Let me
see if it's in the car.
Okay.
One second.
Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
I couldn't find it, but come on, we just go on and get in the car. Girl, you done fell asleep already? Mama. Mom. Come on, girl, we gotta go. Trinity waiting for us. Mom. Wait, whoa. Mama. Mama! Please, God. Mama, please. Oh, Mama. Somebody help.
Thank you.
sunshine. That's not the way it's gonna be. But a little pain mixed with God's sunshine, a little rain to appreciate the good times. Desire is to feel your longing. He feels him just like you, but he don't want you to feel it the same. Mixed with God's sunshine. A little pain mixed with God's sunshine.
Hallelujah, y'all.